All right, here we go with practice test two. Okay? So, who's got an idea about how we might start this problem? So, in other words, think of this, yes. Think of this as a division problem, that's what it is. And then change these guys into their fractions. So what's cosecant? 1/sine. And secant? 1/cosine. And then we have this fraction, excuse me, divided by a fraction. So we will keep, change, flip. Now nothing cancels, but when I multiply them together, I get cosine over sine, which is cotangent. Okay.
Did we get that pink sheet for the test?
Yes. All right, now, what do I do with this guy? It all comes down to, do you know what cosine squared is?
Sine minus 1.
It's 1 minus sine squared. So this is 1 minus sine squared over 1 minus sine. Remember, you have an identity that says sine squared plus cosine squared is 1. So if you move this to the other side, it would say that cosine squared is 1 minus sine squared. Now, nothing cancels at this point. However, what can we do with our numerator?
Take away 1 sine.
Make it cos.
Well, I that is cosine squared, but that would take me right back to where I started. This is factorable. It's the difference of squares. So 1 minus sine, 1 plus sine. You guys are acting like you've never seen this before. We've done that problem before, that exact problem. You have to work on this on your own. You just do, you have to practice. Well, what happens after I factor it? I can cancel, and I'm left with 1 plus sine. Okay. Now we have to solve a triangle. So we're going to find everything that is missing. Okay. Now, when we solve a triangle, we're going to use either the law of sines or the law of cosines. That's it. That's it. It's either going to be law of sines or law of cosines. So kind of check out the situation. What do you notice?
We can figure out what big C is.
We can figure out what big C is, what angle C is. If you have 2 angles, then you can always find the third one, right? So I got 49. BC points. Now what? Yes, Leslie. Now I can do my law of sines. So sine 49 over 10 equals sine 58 over A, for example, I just picked that one. Okay, so now I'm gonna cross multiply. We're all gonna get our calculators out. We're all gonna cross multiply. What did you get for side A? Anybody got it yet? What? 11.24. Now, sometimes we second sign. Not this time, guys. When do we have to use our second sign button?
I'm just solving
when I'm finding an angle, and I am not finding an angle, I'm just using my regular keys, just type, and 11.24. Now, how do I find side B? Same thing?
You do the same thing.
All right, go. Do the same thing. So, sine 49 over 10. Equals this time sine 73 over B. What'd you get?
12.67.
Yep, 12.67. Okay, that's a test question. All right. Now we're going to solve another triangle. Triangles, either law of sines or law of cosines. Period. Two options. All right, which one's appropriate here? It'll have to be cosines because we don't have this. So, e squared equals what? 16 squared plus 10 squared minus 2 times 16 times 10 times cosine 53. It's the law of cosines. Cosine 53. All right, let's type it in. And you know what I'm going to say, right? After we get all this typed in, what do we have to remember to do?
Square
root it, because the law cosines is e squared. And what did we get for side e then when we typed all that in and get square root?
12.78.
Huh?
I was going to tell Jared what I did wrong.
How'd you figure it out?
I did the 16 squared and the 10 squared. I accidentally multiplied instead of adding, and I did all the same stuff, but I got really small.
All right, now what? We're not done. Got a bunch more blanks to fill in. Where do we go from here?
Sine.
Now, can we use our law of sines? So sine 53 over 12.78 equals sine, I don't know, d over 10. So when I solved, my variable is sine d. When I solve, then I'm getting sine d. What do I have to type into my calculator?
Second
sine. So second sine that fraction right there. Did you get 38.68? And then you don't have to really do any more work at this point because now you know two angles. So this guy is 88.32. Triangles are possible. Well, what are our options? We have to show work, so we don't get credit for guessing, but we know that the answer is going to be either what?
0, 1, or 2.
All right, so what do we do? Look at the situation, and what am I going to do?
Law of
sines. I'm going to do the law of sines. Of course I'm going to do the law of sines, because look, sine 73 over 6, sine S over 9. This is going to be just like the one I just finished. Am I going to have a second sign? Yeah, because that's my variable. So go ahead, tell me what angle S works out to be. Sine 52 over 16 equals sine S over 18. All right, type that one in, see what you get. Should have gotten an answer this time. Did you get one?
I got 62.
62.44?
Yeah.
So notice I immediately drew another triangle. this angle is 180 minus my first one. So 180 minus that is 117.56.
Two
triangles. Because can you have a 52 and a 117? Does that make sense? Can I have that in a triangle? Yeah, because what's the only stipulation?
It has to be
less than 180. And this adds up to less than 180, right?
What does it mean when you're drawing more than one triangle? Like, is it just how many can fit in that triangle?
How many would fit that original data?
Oh, okay.
If you said 52, 18, 16, how many possible triangles could be drawn?
Oh, okay.
And there'd be two of them. One with a acute angle and one with an obtuse angle. That, I mean, I didn't draw it to scale. If that's an obtuse angle, I mean, so it would look like this. The shape of it would look like this. So you could have one that's shaped like that, or you could have one that's shaped like that. Okay, last one of those. Figure out what's going on here. Get an answer? What'd you get?
49.91.
What'd you get? I got 50.60. I think it's 50.60. Double check your calculation. And what would that make a possible second angle? 129.4? Remember, this one is always 180 minus your first one.
That's one triangle.
Can you have a 75 and a 129?
No.
Nope. So that one would not be drawable. So that one has one possible triangle. Okay, so again, remember, and you're going to get your quizzes back here in a bit, I think. When I'm grading these, I am looking for that number and this number. This number and this number. Okay? Because that's how you know whether it's one or two. All right, find the area. Okay, what are our options for area? Guys, how do we find area? What are our two options? Hero's formula or 1/2 side sine. Yep. This one would be Hero's formula. So we'll start by finding our perimeter, which is
18.
So our semi-perimeter is 9. So our area will be 9. Minus 7, minus 5, minus 6. Good? What did you say the other way was to find area? Well, look right here. This last problem, 1/2 side sine. There's no work to show there, just the setup. Now, if I'm going to do area for this middle problem, I either need this or I need this kind of thing, right? I don't have that here. So first, I know this angle up here, I'm taking her word for it, is that 47? I don't think so, I don't think it's 47. 45? And I can say sine 45 over 15 equals what?
72
over S or sine 63 over C, it doesn't matter. Okay, so let's find S. Second this one? No. When do we second? If we need an angle. I know all my angles. There's no seconding happening here. What is side S?
20.17.
Now, side S was not my goal. My goal is the area. Now, can I do the area? Because now I have 1/2 side times side times sine of included angle. Make sure if you're using these two sides that you're using that angle. I got 134.79. How about you? All right, one more page. Our little problems. All right, here we go. Pentagon inscribed in a circle. Pentagon, how many sides? Pentagon's five. Hexagon is 6. You might want to review that. So I'm putting 5 little dots around my circle, connecting them. The radius is 10, and my job is to find the area. Okay, so what's our strategy?
360 divided by 5.
Well, think of this as some triangles, and this the central angle here, since there's 5 of them, will be 360 divided by 5. So it's 72. Now look at that triangle. Can I find the area of that triangle? The triangle area is 1 half 10, 10 sine 72. 1 half side, side, sine, just like we did right there. Right? Now what? That's the triangle. I need the pentagon, so I will take that guy right there times 5. Did you get 237.76 square feet? Now we have a parallelogram. The sides are 10 and 16. And the large angle is 104. Now I want the area. Find the area of this top one easily. 1 half side, side, sine. This time, though, after I find that triangle, I won't times it by 5, I will times it by what? 2. So for my parallelogram, I got 155.25 square centimeters. Now this angle up here was 104. Remember that was 104? Who remembers what that makes this one? These two add up to 180. So this one would be 76. Side, side, side. That would be area. We already did that. We need the length of this side. How do we find the length of a side? Two options. Law of sines or law of cosines. Okay. So take a look at it. Going to be law sines or law cosines? Law cosines. X squared equals, I don't know whether I should leave that in or take it out. I'm looking at this triangle right here. X squared equals 10 squared plus 16 squared minus 2 10 16 cosine 76. Last one, decagon. What does that mean? Pen size. Area again. So we'll find this central angle right here, which is 36. 360 of them divided by 10. Can we find the area of the triangle? 1 half, 15, 15, sine 36. And then to get the area of the whole decagon, we will have to take that triangle area times 10. 661.26 square inches. Get it? All right. So now what's going to happen is, I'm going to give you back.
What is this test? Thursday?
Yep. I'm going to give you back your last. I got homework and quizzes here. And I want you, if you missed anything, I want you to find somebody. If you miss something, find somebody with your quiz and get it fixed. Gotta figure out what they're doing. Consult.